When the national media finally got around to reporting on the Trayvon Martin case, there was a sense of disbelief that a neighborhood watch volunteer could fatally shoot an unarmed teenager. But there was also plenty of anger and outrage and histrionics by folks who portrayed George Zimmerman as a cold-blooded murderer. He may be that. I don't know. We in the press didn't have all the facts then, and we don't have all the facts now. What I do know is that some pundits and television lawyers engaged in a rush to judgment based on a narrative that has gotten more complicated, especially with this report from ABC News.
Never before seen publicly picture seems to support George Zimmerman's assertion that he felt he was locked in some sort of life and death struggle with Trayvon Martin that night.
Now, we can't show you the picture because CNN hasn't purchased the rights from ABC, but you've probably seen it. The shot of Zimmerman's badly bloodied head soon after the shooting doesn't prove it was justified, but it does show there was a serious struggle. Meanwhile, the defendant was granted a $150,000 bond on Friday after a prosecutor questioned whether he was playing to the press with his apology.
I wanted to say I am sorry for the loss of your son. I did not know how old he was. I thought he was a little bit younger than I am, and I did not know if he was armed or not.
So that's really addressed to the family and where the media happens to be, correct, Mr. Zimmerman?
No, to the mother and the father.
So while Zimmerman remains behind bars for now, the airways are filled with arguments over whether he should be released. And thanks to the cameras in the Florida courtroom, this is shaping up to be the next O.J. trial. I know this may sound old-fashioned and out of step with our pop-off-first, ask-questions-later culture, but this isn't like arguing over politics or sports. It's a criminal trial, not some cable soap opera designed for our amusement. We just inflame things in this racially charged case by convicting or acquitting the defendant in the court of public opinion. Our on-camera experts might keep that in mind, that they've already gotten out ahead of the facts in this tragedy.